My name is Gijs Klomp. I'm responsible for Jones Lang LaSalle in Romania. We are a leading real estate consultancy firm. My experience dates back for many years in Romania. I was here already as a student in 2000. So I have seen the market evolving through the years. I haven't been living permanently in Romania since then, but I came back regularly and I worked in certain periods in Romania. I've seen tremendous progress being made by the country. Also, Jones Lang in Romania plays a very important role when it comes to advising companies that are willing to enter Romania in their accommodation needs. And because of this, we value the foundation of ABSL in Romania, because we think it's very important for companies to have a platform that will help them in finding their needs in Romania. I think for companies, it's always important when they are making decisions whether to invest in a certain market to have professional advice, and ideally to have a solution that can facilitate various needs. Once a company is moving into a country, there are various fields where they have to get advice on. First of all, of course, it's about where to invest, which country is important, which country is interesting and fits their needs. Then it's about labor. They need to employ people, so they need to find out whether they can find people, what will be the cost of those people, whether those people are fitting the qualifications they are seeking. Of course, once they have made a decision that they can find people, that they are interested in a certain country, they also need to find out more about the tax environment in that country. They need to find out more about the legal environment, the legal framework in which they will operate. And last but not least, of course, once a decision is made to enter into a country, they also need to find accommodation, where to host these people, where can the people work, can they find accommodation that is good enough for their people, that fits their needs, their IT needs, their power supply needs, the number of square meters they need for their people, that is in terms of location close to where they are going to hire the people. Is it a university city? Can they find people enough in that specific city that will want to work with the company? But also, can they find office space where they can accommodate those people? And there, I think Jones Lang comes in, because of course we are a reputable advisor. We have a lot of relationships with international companies that are looking to deploy offshore activities in the service field, exactly the target group of ABSL. We always got requirements from US companies or other international companies that are looking to enter Romania, but we only could facilitate a small part of their requirements, which were related to real estate. And now we are part of a bigger platform together with ABSL, and we can address together with them the full requirement, the full span of needs of a company that is looking to enter Romania. Our niche, of course, is purely focused on office accommodation for those companies. There we have a leading role. We know exactly what tenants need, not only in terms of the location, but also in terms of the building specifications. We know what type of company has specific needs when it comes to HVAC of a building, when it comes to elevator capacity, when it comes to power supply capacity, when it comes to parking needs, when it comes to the micro location within a city, which is the best location to have the best working environment for their employees. So there we can advise companies in that specific field. And also, of course, when it comes to accommodation in a sector which is still very cost sensitive, we can also advise how they can find accommodation that fits, let's say, the budget that is allocated for this purpose. I think we're very excited that ABSL has decided to move to Romania. We know the organization very well from Poland. Our colleagues in Poland have a long-term partnership with ABSL, and they've seen the organization grow tremendously in Poland, where this industry is now representing 10,000 of jobs. I'm not sure about the exact number, but it's really a substantial increase in jobs that were created in this specific sector. And we want to leverage on that relationship, because we believe Romania, perhaps even more than Poland, is an ideal market for companies that are targeting this type of activity. We think the conference will be the perfect launching platform for the organization in Romania. We will show the experiences that were abroad, that were so positive abroad. We also will elaborate on how does Romania fit in the region when it comes to our specific field, which is obviously real estate. So we will elaborate mainly on the real estate availability in Romania for this specific sector needs. I believe 10 years ago it was very difficult for companies that wanted to enter Romania for this purpose to find suitable accommodation. What was available was concentrated only in Bucharest. Now the situation has changed tremendously. Not only in Bucharest, the supply of quality office space with large floor plates, which is very important, of course, for proper internal communication, and also at decent rental levels, has increased tremendously. And now there is ample of supply, alike in any other capital city of the region. On top of that, also companies that don't want to restrict themselves to Bucharest, but are looking at other tier one or tier two cities, such as Cluj, Iași, Brasov, Sibiu, Timișoara. For those companies, we can also now offer modern office space in sufficient quality and sufficient quantity in those cities. So we will also discuss the secondary and tertiary cities of Romania in our study. We will elaborate on costs, of course, which is very important, as mentioned before. We will see what are the costs that a tenant would be facing when entering premises. We'll also look into contractual formats, because of course companies want flexibility, because we all assume that our business will grow, so we would like to have flexibility when it comes to expansion potential of our business. We would like to hire more people when the business is successful, and we want to accommodate them in the same property where we are currently based. We will look into the rental levels as part of cost, but also the other cost components, which people sometimes forget about, the service charges and what is included in those, for example, property tax, which is an important topic. We will also look at locations. What are, for people, important decision factors when it comes to choosing to work for a certain company? In the past, when, of course, the labor market was much more restricted and people were not used to modern office space, people didn't have many requirements when it came to where they would be based. But these days, of course, our employees have grown up in terms of being familiarized with more choice, which is very good and very healthy, but also for companies important to give and to play into this trend and to give accommodation to their staff which is in line with their requirements and which gives them the access to the widest pool of available talent. So it's about accessibility. People want to get easy to the office because they would like to spend time in the office and they would like to spend time at home. Nobody likes to waste time in traffic, obviously, so that's one key factor. And on top of that, of course, people want to have a working climate which is healthy in terms of the temperature that is offered, the proper ventilation of the office space where they're working. They would like to have amenities close to their working space. They would like to have access to cafeteria, to shops for daily needs, to dry cleaning facilities. All of that will be addressed in our presentation. So I think it's a very good opportunity for companies that are interested to invest in this field to listen also to the real estate picture, because real estate, in terms of the overall cost, it's a very significant factor. I think the second largest factor after labor cost. And on top of that, of course, also when it comes to the satisfaction of employees, which will obviously reflect in the quality of their work, it's very important from various surveys how the office space is being selected and how it's being managed, and there we can play an important role. I think it's for the first time in Romania, to my knowledge, I must admit that obviously I'm not knowing everything, so I'm not sure if there was an initial conference in this direction, but as far as I know, to my best knowledge, there never was a Romania conference where all the topics that are relevant for people that are active in this industry were presented under one roof. All the various key topics, the legal, the tax topics, the selection of why Romania, the labor availability, the qualifications of people, the governmental support for this industry, very important of course. What are the government plans in terms of supporting this industry? It brings so many jobs to our country. And last but not least, of course, the real estate side of this business. I think it's a great opportunity for somebody to get in one day the overall view on whether this industry in Romania is of interest to him or her or whether not. And there I think this is the great opportunity of the conference, that it will facilitate the industry as an overall platform, and then of course people that are active in the industry can then select various participants to help them on their specific needs, but they will have one counterparty that can advise on the overall success of establishing a business in Romania in this field. And that's, I think, the great added value, because I think for a company that is exploring this field, it was always very difficult to find its way through the labyrinth of various companies and advisors and consultants that were active. But now this platform, which is endorsed by a number of leading companies that have been active in this field, that know the success story themselves, and rather than being selfish, these companies are not only keeping that success to themselves, but they're also inviting actively other companies to be part of that success and to establish operation in Romania. So I think it's a very good reason, because there is nothing better than following those that were successful already in that field. Mm-hmm. Now, I think for me personally, I believe that one of the key possible successes of Romania as a country, is very dear to me, because I really believe in its potential. I believe in the country as a whole, and especially in the people. I think the most important sales factor for Romania is its labor force. I think this industry, it's not related that much to hard infrastructure like roads or rail network, which Romania still lacks in terms of development. But this industry, what is vital for it is office space that is available, it's labor that is available, qualified labor, enthusiastic labor that is available, that speaks their languages. And there Romania has everything it needs. It has all the people. The people speak tremendous languages, always impressed. And it also was proven by studies that Romanians are the best in Europe as a whole when it comes to the availability of foreign language skills, which is vital for this industry, which is a service industry servicing various countries. It's an industry that's not only servicing Romania, this we have to point out foremost. It's an industry that is serving the entire European, probably even partially global market. So from this perspective, I believe that for the Romanian economy, attracting really in a coordinated way this industry is vital, because it's a sector with a very high value added potential. It's not a sector which will be easily movable, because it's so much linked to the people, to the availability of qualified people. You can move factories, assembly factories, you can move quite easily, as we have learned in the past, also in this region already. But I believe that business which is based on value added created by human creativity and human capital, I think that is the industry where we should focus on our efforts. And Romania has a unique position within the region, because it has the best qualified labor force for this sector. So that's personally my major drive. I really believe that this industry has tremendous growth potential in Romania. So in short, I'm very much looking forward to meet up with you in person at the conference. Please feel free to approach me during the conference with any question, both on Romania as a whole, but especially, of course, on the real estate sector in Romania. And I hope you will all be joining us, and you'll find it a very productive